Megan Rapinoe, this is an incredible honor. I mean, I don't know where to start, but first of all, how do you feel about tonight? I mean, you're receiving an award. You received a lot of awards in your career. What does this mean to you?
Oh, it means so much, to be honest. This really is home in so many different ways. I was just saying on the Fox 13 set, you know, it's been home for my career and somewhere where I really feel like I settled in and matured and found the best of my game here with the rain. It's been my literal home, place I come back to, this calm place, flying into here. This is like flying into no other place in the world. I found Sue here, so I found that heart home. So it feels really good, and honestly, to be honored by this award, which of course is on field, but a lot of it has to do with off field and just knowing the legacy that you know, Paul Allen and his family left and his foundation, to be honored in this way. I'm blushing about it, so it's very special.
So, I mean, folks can kind of tell, you know, from following you on social, but what have you been up to? I mean, I know there's so much that yourself, you've talked about wanting to do. I was at that press conference at that last match and talking about, we don't have a warning, so talking about injuring yourself, using some words I don't know if I can use. I don't fucking care, really. But, I mean, I know Sue's talked about it. I know there's a production company that she's been involved. What has Megan Rapinoe been up to?
Yeah. A lot of rest, to be honest. I have taken a lot of rest, and I think the injury has provided even more space to do that. You know, especially the first 6 weeks, really, I was, like, in the apartment just chilling. I couldn't really do much, and I was pretty inhibited. Got back on my feet, got back on my scooter, did a little bit of that, was able to, you know, honestly, I've been able to do things I never would have been able to do, like
Absolutely.
Go to Jess and Z's wedding, you know, take just a quick 3-day trip. I've been to a few events with Sue just mm-hmm. as Sue's girlfriend and being able to be there for her, you know, been to a couple games, traveled a little bit, but honestly, I was pretty intentional towards the end of my season, knowing I was going in retirement, like I wanted a little time to rest, and now we're kicking back up again. This is kind of the first of a string of events that we have going the next couple months, and feels good to be back out in the world a little bit.
Absolutely. I just saw some of those Instagram stories of you on the scooter, and I was like, that's Megan. Of course it is.
I mean, I tore it up. I tore it up. I don't know what to say.
And to go back to it, you talked about Seattle being a home in multiple ways. I was just speaking with KJ Wright, who wants to meet you. So if you see KJ Wright,
KJ.
Make sure you go bother him. It's another bald head to look at. At least for you, you know, from, you know, further down the West Coast, what aspects of this area have just stuck out to you where you want to keep coming back and want to stay involved? Because I know you mentioned, you know, with the rain and the sail of the rain, you want to be involved. Sue's been involved with the storm as well. Why, for you, is that something that you do want to be a part of and want to be a part of in this area?
Sometimes I just feel like home chooses you, and this is what that felt like. I've, you know, talked really openly about how I got here and how I was pissed to come here because I went to school in Portland. I was like, how am I not being placed in Portland? I was so mad. But coming here, you know, meeting Bill and Teresa Predmore, who own the team, originally the original founders of the team, those are family to me. Having Laura Harvey as my coach for almost my entire career here, growing up here, like, I feel like I really became an adult here. Some of the most trying times of my life were here. Some of the best times of my life were here. I met Sue here, obviously. So there's just something about flying back into this city, the way it glistens, especially in the summer. It's a little dreary in the winter, but that's okay too. There's just something special about being here. I think it's all the memories and the people and just knowing that, like, I think I found myself here too. So. Yes, yeah, it's a lot of levels to why we love it so much here. I think we'll always call this place home and always spend a lot of time here. And then obviously our teams are here. I mean, I can't imagine really rooting for anybody else. It just feels right to continue to be a part of this incredible sports landscape and especially our two teams.
To that point, are you able to reveal anything about how you'd want to be involved with the rain, or you just know that you want to be involved somehow? Whoever that ultimately falls into place. Is there anything you've got in mind, or?
Not specifically. I mean, I always want to be able to hit Laura and have her do exactly what I think. she rarely did. No, I mean, I just want to be involved. I feel like for me, my most impactful involvement would be stuff off the field. I mean, I love the game, and you know, I feel like obviously I was a great player in so many ways, but I think there's people that are a lot more qualified. I feel like what I can do off the field business-wise, and just kind of tapping into sort of like the essence of the team, essence of the city, and how to continue to grow this into something that we really feel like it could be, which is huge. You know, the last game, home game that we played in here, 30-something thousand. Last playoff game a couple years ago, 20,000. Like, I think that can be the norm, and I feel like I can be a part of speaking that into existence and be one of the architects of that.
Does Seattle have the two best men's and women's crests in the country? I mean, I'm asking someone who's pretty stylish, so I just
pretty fire
want to get that opinion.
Pretty fire.
If I had to put you in a different uniform of any of our Seattle teams, who would you pick and why? I've asked Lou. She said she'd step onto the court for the Storm. Do you have an idea of what you'd want to do?
No question. I'm going Storm. I can't wear 15 because, you know, legend, yeah. LJ. We're not taking the 15 down from the rafters to put it on me. I know that's for sure. I got 6 fouls every game. I'm wild, so I'll do some wild stuff. I'm like the worst possible version of Steph Curry.
Ah,
like,
okay.
Whatever that, like, okay. What's the worst, what, like, Steph's obviously the best version of Steph Curry. What's the worst? That's me with, okay, like, maybe 2 points a game and 6 fouls.
Well, I would love to see that. I know they do Champions of Change. Maybe when you feel like it, we'll get you out to that. But
yeah, once I get my Achilles right, I'm out.